Rabbi David, Rabbi David.
Rabbi David.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Borei Pri Ha'Adama.
Welcome to Pickle Week. This is the Milken Morning Show, and we're back. Do you remember?
Today is the Wednesday of Pickle Week, and if you notice that some people might be wearing pickle costumes, that means that you should read your email more often, because today is Dressed Like a Pickle Day. Any other news?
This past Monday and also Tuesday, there was tournaments for pickleball, and there's a final today, I think at lunch, don't quote me on that, and the senior breakfast will also be tomorrow.
Right now, I'm joined by Mr. Mahoney, who is unfortunately leaving us to go on what?
A world cruise.
A world?
For 5 months.
For 5 months.
Yep. Starting January 11th. It was a tough decision to make to leave Milken, but it was an opportunity I couldn't pass up.
So tell us, what are you most excited for about this cruise?
I mean, we're going all sorts of places. We start here in LA, and then we go to Hawaii, Samoa, Tonga, New Zealand, Australia, all through Polynesia, all through Asia, then through the Suez Canal to Egypt, and then through the Middle East a little bit, and then end in Greece.
It sounds great. I'm jealous. I wish I could go. You know, I fit into a carry-on, so you could totally sneak me on.
Yeah, I've got big luggage, so.
Do you think that you could send us a selfie in each country that you're in, and we could include it in the morning show as a Mahoney,
update.
Mahoney's missions? You're not like converting anyone to Christianity, but.
Yeah, I'd be happy to do that.
Cool. Who are you going on the cruise with?
I'm actually going with my mom, which is kind of weird, but she's turning 70 this coming year. And so I thought it would be good to spend some time with her. She also worked for a subsidiary of the cruise company, so we got a really sweet deal on the cruise. So it worked out well.
Okay, cool. Well, we're really gonna miss Mr. Mahoney here at Milken Community School, Community Education School, High School.
As will I.
My name is Miles. What are your guys' names?
Richard.
Jerome.
How long have you been working for you at PS?
23 years.
4 years.
What is the hardest delivery in terms of driving you've had to do? Because I just saw you going down like a skinny, narrow hallway of cars.
Yeah, probably those narrow hills. That's probably the hardest. Those little streets on Mulholland, Beverly Glen.
Do we know what we're delivering today?
I have no clue. I know there's 5 boxes.
5 boxes. Milken, we're getting 5 boxes. Sounds great.
Here with Mr. Madnikoff, my history teacher, for an interview. Hello, Mr. Madnikoff.
Hello, hello.
So yesterday, when I confirmed our interview, you told me you were going to plan your outfit according to our interview and make it something interesting. So tell us about your outfit.
So today, because I'm teaching Pearl Harbor, I wore a nice tropical outfit, rocking the pea coat and the white shoes. And for my children, I wore Ninja Turtle socks.
Love to see it. So Mr. Madnikoff, tell us about your college football and what team you're interested in.
I used to be known around campus as the guy who wore all Florida Gators stuff, but they suck right now, so I don't wear any more of that. I still support them, but it's a hard time to be a Gator fan.
What's your favorite snack from the Milken Mart?
I don't know if you know this, but I've never bought a single thing at the Milken Mart, ever.
Not even the Old Mart?
Not even the Old Mart.
What would you be interested in trying? Like, what do your students tell you is really good?
Well, my love for pickles and upcoming Pickle Week, I'd probably buy pickles.
Yeah, I agree with that. They have some pretty good pickles. Thank you, Mr. Madnikoff.
Of course, thank you.
Right now, we're at the pickleball tournament. How long have you been pickleballing?
I've been pickleballing since I was just a wee little boy. Since I was just little. When I was just little boy.
Mr. Rayner, yes. How long have you been balling for?
Have I been balling? My whole life.
Your whole, since day one. He came out of the womb with a wiffle ball in his left hand and a paddle in his right.
Oh, we're talking pickleball. I've only done that once.
Oh. What do you have to say about pickles as a whole and what they mean to this community?
That's a great question. Pickles are such a thing in the Jewish community. You know what I mean? Like, it's cross Ashkenazi Sephardic. Like, we all love pickles. It's really our unifier.
As it says in Bava Metzia 89b, let there be pickle, come one, come all, eat thy pickle and feel it all. That's a direct quote. Thank you, Rabbi Sean.
Thank you so much for this beautiful year on the morning show. We'll see you next year.
We'll see you next year. I hope everyone has a great winter break. Bye! Love
was changing.